up garage. Sorry I'm not excited. I am excited, but really not because I'm not a morning person. But today, I'm going to be changing the intake on the Grinch. As you can see, my husband's not here because last time he took my car without asking me and cut the resonator off. And yeah, I didn't know. But I kind of knew he was doing something because he said he was checking the fluids. But I fired him. He's not allowed to touch my car again. I'm going to do this myself. So anything that is on the Grinch, I'm doing myself. Okay? So we're going to change the intake on this. And I may call things wrong because you know what? I'm a girl. I don't know this stuff. So if you come over here with me, I will show you what we're going to do. Got my tools. See? I don't know. They're sockets or something. I don't know. But I got them. I think they're the right ones. And then I have this. I believe this is a filter. I think. I'm going to read the instructions. I promise. Okay. And then I don't really think that's going to fit back in the car. But everybody tells me it will. I just don't think it will. I don't know. And then we have some rubber tubes, some gaskets. No, that's not what those are called. Some kind of rings. Some more stuff, and more stuff. And I don't know where it all goes, so I have to read these instructions because I don't know.
Do you want to tell them what it is?
It is a, should I read this? Astida. Astida 2015 Plus S550 Mustang GT Open Cold Air Intake. Instructions. So I know that I need this socket right here because that's the, excuse you. That's the first step in the instructions. I need a 15 millimeter deep well socket in this thing. Zach tells me it's a ratchet, but this kind of looks like a drill to me. Anyways.
It's an impact, but it'll work just fine.
Oh, sorry. It's an impact. Sorry. And I really don't know how to put this on here. Okay. If you hear background noise and you can't hear me, that's the guy I just fired. So wait, or stay tuned for the next episode, okay? You'll get it. He's just gonna be really loud. All right, so let's go. I believe I have to take everything off first in the Grinch, okay? So I gotta read these real quick. So come back in just a minute, okay? All right, so I'm gonna show you what we're gonna take off, but I'm not gonna bore you with the whole take each step taking stuff off because it's gonna be super long. So I'll just tell you what we're gonna do and then you just watch. We're doing a time lapse, you just watch it, and then after it we'll be back. Okay, so first thing we gotta take off this bar to get to the engine cover. Should we just pop these two things off, as they say, and lift it up? And then we'll be, I keep saying we, it's me. I'm going to be taking this intake cover off. All the tubes, disconnect everything. Take this box out, which I'm assuming that the other box that I said wouldn't fit in here, that's this. Because I didn't realize this was down here. And then we're gonna be deleting the sound tube. We don't want that thing in there. It's not okay. We don't need a sound tube, okay? We're gonna make this cool.
We'll be right back. people, guess what? I got unfired. You know why? Because she couldn't take the old sound tube off. You know, the old tube. She couldn't get it off. I had to come out here. You know, I'm just saying, you can fire me, but you always take me back. So, we'll go ahead and just delete on that.
I wanted to do that. As you can see, everything is out. It's a bit dirty under here. So we're gonna replace this. But I can tell you the hardest part was taking that sound tube out, okay? It's attached to something, I have no idea, but I had to hire my husband back to pull it out. And then you have to put like this little plug in there, and that was hard too. If you have big hands and big arms, you're not getting in there. Sorry. Go get your wife to do it, okay? If she has little hands and arms. So now let's come over here. And we've got to take this part off right here. This is the old box, okay? And then we got to put it on the new box. And we'll do a comparison of this box to the new box, okay? Okay, so check out this difference of these boxes. This one's a lot bigger. A lot bigger. So I'm gonna go ahead and attach the, I don't know what it's called, the other piece that was on here. I'm gonna attach it to this and I'm gonna put it in, okay?
Okay guys, so on this particular intake, it needs a tune. So there's two different intakes. There's ones that require tunes and ones that don't. Really, to gain performance, you want the one with the tune. Yeah, that's just better. So looking in here, I don't know how well you can see, but there's a lot of restriction in there. So this one, not so much. But so for the tune change, and I'm not gonna go over everything here because every vehicle is different, but this is the same concept whether you're doing this on a Mustang, a Honda Civic, a Chevy truck, whatever you have, this is very similar to what you'd have to do. So I'm using calipers, but what you do is you measure as close to where the mass airflow sensor goes. So the mass airflow sensor goes in here and sticks through. I've already moved it to the new tube, but you measure the inside diameter as close to the mass airflow sensor as you can. So this particular one is 3¾ inches in diameter. And write that number down. Now, this is easier before you put all this together, otherwise you've got to take it all apart and remeasure this. Do the same thing on your new intake. Measure as close to in there as you can, and this is 4½ inches. And write that number down. Now, there's a math formula, and I won't provide it because it's different for every vehicle. You put in your existing mass airflow sensor numbers, the diameter of your tube, and what the tune-up has for numbers in it. You put in your new diameter of your new pipe, and it'll do the math, and it calculates what the mass airflow sensor should be reading, basically to compensate for this significantly larger, more free-flowing intake.
All right, we're gonna put it in. It's all put together, I think. So you stick it down in here.
This one's gonna be tight.
It's gonna be tight.
Don't worry. So.
Oh, hang on, I'm stuck right there.
That needs to go over into there.
Mm-hmm.
Snake underneath this, it goes underneath there.
How do I know if it's on there? All right, let's put this on.
Start by hand. You can let go of the box now.
Okay, so we got everything installed. Look at this. I recommend don't go by the instructions, okay? Don't be a girl. Just put it in, because it's not right. Okay, so this is the last part. I'm gonna put this on and then put everything back together and we'll be done. I'm very bad at this tool. Okay, there we go. Now I'm gonna put everything else on and we'll be back. All right, we've finished the install of everything, put everything back together. It's all tuned by my lovely son, Zach. If you don't know how to tune, get a professional, or a lot of places sell a tune kit with the intake. No, that's not what it's called. Yeah, the intake air thing. Okay, so now we're gonna start it up, see what it sounds like. Okay, so there you go. If you like this, let me know, comment down below what else I can do to this, because I'm gonna do a lot. Be sure to like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time. Peace out.